What happened? What happened? To go to debate in a place when you find people swear to Allah, to Prophet, the emotional Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the word, نسأل الله تعالى العافية. And you hear someone say Aisha this and that, radiallahu ta'ala ala. How can you stay there? How can you stay there? Wallahi, listen. It's not something to say, I'm going to say my word, I will go. Yes.
I'm telling you.
To listen to the dog, what he says. It will harm you. Sooner or later. Sooner it will harm you.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد ألا وإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد جزاكم الله خيرا. I wanted to carry on what I said last week about debate, people of innovation, to bring what Salaf Saleh they said about it. It's not something easy or something not important. We have to know this is from our greed, from our qaqidah. We have to know this. Because of, I brought with me kitab Sharh Sunnah lil Imam Barbahaare rahimahullah, and who explained it is Sheikh Al-Fawzaan hafidhahullahu ta'ala. I will read just what he said, what he said, Imam al-Barbahaare. If we need some explanation, inshallah, we'll do it bi-idhnillah. يقول, I will read in Arabic. I want to try. سعيد, تعال تعال تعال. لا تصحح لي إذا ما أخطأت. تعال تعال تساعدني بارك الله فيك. تعال تعال, أمر مهم بارك الله فيك. ما تقرأ ولا شيء, أنا أقرأ, إذا ما أخطأت صحح لي. ها,
حاول.
لا اقترب 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 يا رجل. أنا أقرأ بالعربي. I will read in Arabic. ثم after that I will read translation in English. And if I need to read some explanation from الشيخ صالح الفوزان, I will do it إن شاء الله. Okay. قال الإمام البربهاري رحمه الله, وإذا أردت الاستقامة على الحق وطريق أهل السنة فقبلك فاحذر الكلام وأصحاب الكلام والجدال والمراء والقياس والمناظرة في الدين, فإن استماعك منهم وإن لم تقبل منهم يقدح الشك في القلب وكفى به قبولا فتهلك. وما كانت زندقة قط ولا بدعة ولا هوى ولا ضلالة إلا من الكلام والجدال والمراء والقياس, وهي أبواب البدعة والشكوك والزندقة. الإمام البربهاري, may Allah have mercy on him, said, if you entered steadfastness, يعني الاستقامة, to be straight away, you know, right path, upon the truth and the way of the followers of a sunnah before you, avoid theological theoretic and the people of rhetoric, yeah? Argument, you have to avoid argument. Dispute, analogy and debate in the religion. For your hearing from them, even if you did not accept a word from them, create, if you're hearing from them, create a doubt in the heart, and it suffice as acceptance, and you become destroyed, and heresy, innovation, desire, or misguidance has never occurred except as a result of rhetoric, argumentation, dispute, and analogy. They are the gate of innovation, doubt, and heresy. Heresy. Okay. This is first what he said, Imam al-Barbahaare,
I think is so clear, so clear.
You are not allowed to debate people of innovation. Be careful.
Second one, what he said, rahimahullah. Now, 59. قال رحمه الله وقف عند متشابه القرآن والحديث ولا تقص شيئا. The author, may Allah have mercy on him, said, hold back at the متشابه. متشابه, how to say it in this
ambiguous.
Yeah. Hold back at the المتشابه ambiguous verse in the Quran and Sunnah, and do not analyze anything nor engage in analogy regarding anything. And what he said after, this is important, barakallahu fikum. And he said, قال المؤلف وإذا سألك أحد من عن مسألة في هذا الباب about المتشابه, if someone asks you about it, وهو مسترشد فكلمه وأرشده وإذا جاءك يناظرك فاحذر فإن في المناظرة المراء والجدال والمغالبة والخصومة والغضب وقد نهيت عن جميع هذا جدا وهو يزيل عن طريق الحق ولم يبلغن عن أحد من فقهائنا وعلمائنا أنه ناظر أو جادل أو خاصم. قال البربهاري, may Allah have mercy on him, if anyone asks you about an issue on this subject, about المتشابه, about greed, while seeking forgiveness, you have to now speak to him and guide him. But if he comes to you debating, be conscious of him. This is because in debating there is disputation, argumentation, exaggeration, quarrel, and anger. And you have been seriously warned against all this because it deviates from the right path. This stuff deviates. Don't take, no, it's okay for me. No, it's not okay. You don't know. But this is what happened. A lot of people, they did it. They've been deviated from right path. If has not reached us from anyone among our jurists and scholars that be he debated or argued or Carulate, yes. Okay, another verse, 2074. قال المؤلف قال الحسن البصري رحمه الله الحكيم لا يماري ولا يداري حكمته ينشرها إن قبلت حمد الله وإن ردت حمد الله وجاء رجل للحسن فقال أنا أناظرك في الدين فقال الحسن أنا عرفت ديني فإن ضل دينك فاذهب فاطلبه. He said, رحمه الله, حسن البصري, may Allah have mercy on him, said, the wise does not argue or debate. The wise does not argue or debate. He disseminates his wisdom. If it is accepted, he praised Allah, and if he is rejected, he praised Allah. A man came to Hassan al-Basri and said, I want to debate with you concerning the religion. So he said, Rahimahullah, I know my religion. So if your religion is lost, then go and look for it. This is people of debate. They lost their religion. This is reality. They don't know what they have. You will find him in this stuff. Then after a while, they will change to other. As ذلك, what said scholar, صاحب البدعة لا يتوب من بدعة إلا بدعة أخرى. Oh, people of innovation, they don't repent from بدعة just to other بدعة. He will leave this one to other one. Why? And utul jadal, argument, debate, just what they want to talk about religion. And with no knowledge. This is a big problem. Yeah. No, yeah. قال رحمه الله وسمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قوما على باب حجرته يقول أحدهم ألم يقل الله كذا ويقول الآخر ألم يقل الله كذا فخرج مغضبا فقال أبهذا أمرتكم أم بهذا بعثت إليكم أن تضربوا كتاب الله بعضه ببعض فنهاهم عن الجدال.
The author, may Allah have mercy on him, said, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam heard of people at the door of his apartment while one of them said, did Allah not say such and such? And the other said, did Allah not say such and such? So he came out angrily. He was ghadib. Why? And said, is this what I have commanded to you? Or it is this what I have been sent with to you? Should you set an aspect of the book of Allah against the others? So he forbid them from debate.
You know, we've got just permission to debate in one thing.
Umur al-fiqhiyya, ahkam al-shar'iyya, stuff of al-fiqh. If there is a different opinion,
but with what one condition we seek truth about it.
For example, this we debate about put your hand after ruku', you put your hand in your chest after ruku'. There is two opinion about it.
We debate about it. Give me your proof. I will give you my proof. Two, for our attention to be seeking what truth.
Not to show ourselves I've got knowledge better than you, or just to harm ourselves, to divide. If these things
result about it divided, means it will be bid'ah. You are in a bid'ah, wal'iyadu billah. But in the religion, in the aqidah, it's haram to debate.
Don't tell me, Sheikh al-Islam or
Imam Ahmad.
When Imam Ahmad, he was debate Ahl al Biddah. When? He didn't have choice. He'd been in jail. He would sit for 16 years. He has to do it. Otherwise, these people of innovation, they will win at that time. If he didn't debate them, and who pushed him to debate? It's the rulers at that time. Yes or no? How come you take yourself and you think about yourself, I can't do it. I will go to Hyde Park Corner, I will debate the people there.
Al-Khawarij, Al-Rawafid, or people of innovation, all of them. I will debate any one of them.
Or kuffar. It's not the way of Salaf-Salah. Never been.
They did it because they were in need. They didn't have choice.
And you have to know, to debate in front of people, no, this is not a way of Salaf Salah.
If someone come to you, you want to talk, okay. If you think he's looking for truth, okay, talk to him, debate him between you and him. But if you debate in front of people, maybe they will come with the doubt, and you don't have an answer because your people who were listening to you, they will be misguided. Yes or no? Because you give this opportunity for this mubtada, for this person of innovation, to split his bid'ah. Yes or no? And Akhi, it's not anyone, even Sheikh Rabi Hafidhahullah Ta'ala, he said even some ulama, some scholar, they cannot debate because they have weakness in some stuff.
He's a scholar, yes, but it's not anyone can debate. It's best of them. Like Sheikh Al-Albani. Like Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah. But look, Sheikh Al-Albani,
how he do it? How he did it?
Huh? In front of people. Or in houses. And look how he is strong.
Huh? No one can, alhamdulillah, because Allah gave him a lot of knowledge, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. He knows Sunnah. In the same time, he knows a bid'ah. Same thing, Sheikh Al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah.
He knows the Sunnah, in the same time, he knows the Bid'ah. He knows the Bid'ah, and he knows how to refute it with a proof.
And this guy, people who went to hide by a corner,
majority of them, when they seek knowledge,
How long they been seeking knowledge? From who they seek knowledge? What is their source? Google. I have to look for information.
Akhi, even this book. This book, Sheikh Al Fawzan, he explained it. Yes or no?
I think Sheikh Nu'man, he did with the Sharh Sunnah Al Barbahaare. Because of people who is in the masjid who went there, what you are doing? Did you miss all these lectures?
You've got this is Sharh Sunnah Al Barbahaare. This is what Salaf Salih been following in Al Aqidah.
How come? I don't know, you went there, how?
And you study it, if you study, I don't know. You study this, and look, I'm reading from where? From Sharh al-Barbahari, yeah. Sharh al-Sunnah, al-Imam al-Barbahari. And it's been teached in this masjid.
What happened? What happened?
To go to debate in a place when you find people swear to Allah, to Prophet, the mentioned Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, with the word Nas Allah Ta'ala al-Afiya, huh? And you hear someone say Aisha this and that, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. How can you stay there? How can you stay there?
Wallahi, listen.
It's not something to say, oh, no, I'm going to say my word, I will go. Yes.
I'm telling you.
To listen to the dog, what he said? It will harm you. Sooner or later. Sooner it will harm you. Yes, you can give a lecture and break their doubt and refute it. No problem. You say, Khawarij, they said this and that. This is answer of this. No problem.
But to debate, huh? And someone come, you come with the Qala Allah, Qala Rasul, or Shi'i come with Qala Allah, Qala Rasul, and maybe you will not find, he will not give you opportunity to answer him.
What is the result of that?
Be careful. This is religion. Don't play with your religion. Don't play with your deen. You will be first one
harmed, then others because you.
Than others because you.
Na'am.
I think I've got another one.
قال المؤلف رحمه الله يكره المناظرة وكان ابن عمر رضي الله عنه يكره المناظرة ومالك بن أنس ومن فوقه ومن دونه إلى يومنا هذا وقول الله عز وجل أكبر من قول الخلق قال الله تبارك وتعالى ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا وسأل رجل عمر بن الخطاب فقال من ناشطات نشطاء فقال لو كنت محلوقا لضربت عنقك وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن لا يماري ولا أشفع للمماري يوم القيامة فدعوا المراء لقلة خيره وإن كان this last hadith is weak but what he said, rahimahullah. He said, Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to dislike debate and malik. Dislike in a term, in a word of Salaf Sahim is haram. It's not like dislike what we understand. It's not the same. We have to know. It's not the same meaning. Means haram. When if you hear Salaf Sahim said, we dislike this, means haram. Means haram.
He said, Ibn Umar used to dislike this debate and Malik ibn Anas and those before and after him till this time of ours.
You get it? Be careful. Don't say I'm bitter. I know what I'm doing. You don't know. You are going to lose your religion.
If you lose your religion, what you will have? Nothing.
We'll have nothing.
Because a Muslim without religion, without
right greed, right belief, he's nothing. He's nothing.
If you've got a doubt,
khalas. If you start doubt to get in your heart,
khalas. You're finished. Wal'iyadu billah. Why? Because you put yourself in a situation, you are not at that level.
Ibn Sirin.
Huh? Come, I will just read one ayah. No.
I will not hear from you. Why?
Because he was afraid, if he just read in ayah, a doubt get inside his heart. No, I will not hear from Mubtada. Ayah or had, I will not hear from him.
He said, yeah. The statement of Allah, the mighty and sublime, is greater than the statement of the creatures. Allah, the blessed and exalted, say, no one dispute concerning the verse of Allah except those who disbelieve it.
This is like a debate. This kind of people.
And man asked Umar ibn al-Khattab the meaning of by those angels who remove the soul of the believers with ease. Umar said, had it been you were shaved, I would have struck your neck.
Because he thought he was one from al-Khawarij. Rebellion. Because in the Prophet Muhammad, when he described al-Khawarij, he said they shaved their hair.
As he said, if you shaved your hair, I will
take off your hat. Why? Because he was asking about the mutashabih. Because he has doubt in his heart. You see, this from Salaf Salah. Don't sit with people of innovation. Don't talk to them. Don't talk to them. Don't debate them. It's not enough to preserve your religion. It's not enough for you. Huh? Then, barakallahu fiqh, be careful.
Yes. And I just write what this is. Imam al-Barbahaare, what he said in Sharh al-Sunnah. You will find Imam ibn Battah al-Ukbari, أبو عثمان إسماعيل الصابوني عقيد السلف وأصحاب الحديث الإمام الكائي شرح أصول أهل السنة والجماعة and
he mentioned
نقل الإجماع أهل العلم والسنة على الكف عن الجدال والمناظرة فيما سبيلهم اعتقاده بالأفئدة مما ليس تحته عمل في كتابه للإذكار الإجماع how to say
consensus الكائي emotion naqala consensus about self is haram to debate
in about stuff of aqeedah is haram to debate about it
except
as what he said al-fiqh what he says scholars in
matter of fiqh no problem something has one or two opinion three opinion you can debate it
but with attention to the second what truth. And this
debate doesn't
take us to divide it and to harm each other.
Otherwise, we have to leave it.
And even الحافظ أبو قاسم إسماعيل الأصبهاني في كتابه الحجة في بيان المحجة وشرح عقيدة أهل السنة الإمام الآجوري في الشريعة
all this أئمة and before and after them the emotion is haram to debate. Don't debate people of innovation. And don't think you know. Don't think you know.
Remember, each time
you get a new thing, you get or you know in a new thing, you have to remember you are ignorant.
You have to remember each time you know something.
Each time you know something new about religion means you are ignorant.
And we are. And we are.
And we are. Be careful, ya akhi. Don't play with your religion.
And don't go there. Just I want to see, to have fun, like to have fun.
No. You know, Salaf Saleh, one of them, when he's walking and he see people of innovation talking, he put his finger like this. Not to hear nothing. Why? From ear to the heart. Maybe that time Shaitan make it so beautiful
and it will be in your heart. And from that time you will be divided from Sunnah. You will be going far, a little bit far, and you will leave Sunnah wal-iyadu billah.
Look, Al-Harawi, he was Sheikh al-Islam. He was a student of Daraqutni. Daraqutni is Imam Sunnah. Daraqutni is Imam Sunnah. But what happened to Harawi? Imam Daraqutni, he met Al-Baqillani, and he was Ash'ari. Huh?
And Al-Baqillani
has refuted a lot of people of innovation, like Khawarij.
When he met him, he was pleased. He was so happy. He was so happy to meet him. This is
made Shaykh al-Islam al-Harawi become Ash'ari. And he was from ulama al-Hadith. He was one of who wrote Sahih al-Bukhari, all Sahih al-Bukhari.
He said, why you become Ash'ari? Look, because my Sheikh, look what he did to Al-Baqillani.
Because I thought he said this, he thought what he has Al-Baqillani is right.
Then he followed Al-Baqillani for Al-Aqidah.
You see, don't say, I'm sitting with Ahl al Biddah, but I'm strong enough. You're not. And who can sit with them? This scholar is a big scholar. Look, Sheikh Rabi'i said, I mentioned it. Even some scholars, they cannot do it.
Because he has some weakness in his ill. No one is perfect.
Because we find many scholars, they don't debate. Few of them. And majority of them, when they debate, because they didn't have a choice. They didn't have a choice. Then, akhi, jazakallahu khairan, don't put your religion, your aqidah in scale. You will lose it. Don't take a risk. Wallahi, don't take a risk. It's not worth it. Wallahi, is not worth it. Just seek knowledge. Try to memorize the Quran. Try to learn Arabic. It's shame. Many times I think about it. Wallahi, it's shame.
We are all Muslim. الذي يجمع بيننا. Who is make us? Is our religion one in a nation? Yes.
This religion is Arabic. Language is Arabic. It's shame of us. We talk English. We don't talk Arabic.
I'm not talking about those who become Muslim recently. I'm
talking about who are born Muslim. You're born Muslim and you don't know Arabic. Huh? You're born Muslim and you're still talking about religion, another language.
Isn't shame this? You don't feel shame?
Huh? And a lot of us, they came from a Muslim country, they don't know English.
Maybe he never studied English. When he came here, he became talking English. Yes or no?
And what about Arabic? And what about Arabic? Think about it. Think about it, Barakallahu fik. Wallahi, shame. Min al-mufrod. We have to talk. We don't have in masjid Arabic because we are Muslim. And the Islam language of Islam is what? English, Spanish, French. No, it's in Arabic.
How come we are talking English? And you see, my English is so good. I don't mind.
Trust me, I don't mind. Wallahi, I don't mind my English in this level. Main thing, I will try to learn always, I will try to progress in Arabic. This is the main thing for me. English, it will come, inshallah. It will not come, I don't mind.
I don't mind, trust me.
But you are Muslim. You have to learn Arabic. First
objective, to learn Arabic. To read the Quran. To try to talk Arabic. This is the way.
And you stay 10 years, 20 years, you become 30, 40, 60. Nothing. What did you do for your life? Just looking for a risk, looking for a work, looking for money. Huh? If, for example, one of us, he need to have some skill, yeah, to have something, he will go to study, yes or no? Yes or no? And what about Arabic?
trust me, you will never test religion in other language except Arabic. You will not test it. You like or you don't like. I'm sorry. This is truth and this is reality. You cannot test the Quran in other language. Other language is meaning. But you test the Quran in Arabic. You test the Sunnah in Arabic. You test this, our religion, in Arabic. But be careful, Jazakumullah. May Allah guide us. May Allah, يعرفنا بقدر أنفسنا.
Allah wants us to know our own levels.
Huh?
Allah wants us to know our own levels.
Allah allows us to know our level. This is the main thing. إذا عرفت نفسك, you know where you are. بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
شفت قبل الأمس كنت عند